A very good morning, student. The next topic is collision. Collision is a common phenomenon that happens around us every now and then. For example, carrom, billiards, marbles, etc. Collision can happen between two bodies with or without physical contact. So please note it down. What is meant by collision? Collisions can happen between two bodies with or without physical contact. Now, the linear momentum is conserved in all collision process. Please note it down, children. This is objective question. Linear momentum is conserved in all collision process. When two bodies collide, the mutual impulsive force means force, product of the force and the time. The mutual impulsive force acting between them during the collision time, del T, produces a change in their respective momenta. That is, first body exerts a force F21 vector on the second body. F21 vector means the second body experiences a force due to the first. Second body experiences a force due to the first. From the Newton's third law, the second body exerts a force F12 vector on the first body. That means the first body experiences force due to the second body. This causes a change in momentum. Change in momentum, symbol of change in momentum is del P1 vector and del P2 vector. This is the change in momentum symbol of the first body and the second body respectively. Now the relation could be written as, relation is del P1 vector can be written as, already we know the formula for the impulsive force, del P1 vector is equal to F12 vector into del T. Then del P2 vector is equal to F21 vector into del T. Adding equation 4.44 and 4.45, we get del P1 vector plus del P2 vector is equal to, just substituting the value, F12 vector into del T plus F21 vector into del T. Del T is the common value. Remove the common terms. So we obtain F12 vector plus F21 vector into del T. According to the Newton's third law, F12 vector is equal to minus of F21 vector, because both the bodies are acting in the opposite direction, impulse to each other means. So the force acting in the opposite direction, that is why F12 vector is equal to minus of F21 vector. So the answer is, the substituting the value of this F12 vector can be written as minus F21 vector, means this term is cancelled to each other, that means zero. Zero into anything, zero. So the equation becomes del P1 vector plus del P2 vector is equal to zero. So here del is the common value, remove the common term, del into P1 vector plus P2 vector is equal to zero. Dividing both sides by del T and taking limits del T to 0. So 0 to del T, that means beginning time is 0. Final time means change in time del T. We get the next step of equation. Limits del T to 0. Del into P1 vector plus P2 vector divided by del T is equal to, del symbol can be written as difference. Difference means D. So D into P1 vector plus P2 vector divided by dt is equal to 0. The above expression implies that the total linear momentum is a conserved quantity. Total linear momentum is a conserved quantity. Note, the momentum is a vector quantity. Hence, vector condition has to be followed to find the total momentum of the individual bodies in collision. So please note it down, children. The momentum is a vector quantity. This is an important objective type question. The momentum is a vector quantity. Then next topic is types of collisions. types of collision. In any collision process, the total linear momentum and the total energy are always conserved, whereas the total kinetic energy need to be conserved always. Some part of the initial kinetic energy is transformed to another form of energy. This is because the impact of collision and deformation occurring due to collisions any in general produce heat, sound, light, etc. When the two bodies are impact or impulsed to each other, collide with each other, which is produce another one form of energy. It is nothing but heat, sound and light, etc. By taking these effects into account, we classify the types of collision as follows. First type of collision is elastic collision. Then second type of collision is inelastic collision. So what is meant by elastic collision? So this is a 2-mark question. Please note it down. Listen carefully. What is meant by elastic collision? In a collision, the total initial kinetic energy of the bodies before collision is equal to the total final kinetic energy of the body after collision. Then it is called as the elastic collision. So total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after collision is nothing but elastic collision. Because elastic means the object regains its original position after removal of deforming force. That is why total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. Inelastic collision means it is not equal. Total kinetic energy of the bodies before collision is not equal to the total kinetic energy of the bodies after collision. Then it is called as inelastic collision. That is, total kinetic energy before collision is not is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. This is very, very important. 2-mark question, children. Please note it down. The next formula is total kinetic energy before collision minus total kinetic energy after collision is nothing but loss in energy during collision. That means del Q. Loss in energy during collision, that means del Q. Even though kinetic energy is not conserved, but the total energy is conserved. Kinetic energy is not conserved, but the total energy is conserved. So this is because the total energy contains the kinetic energy term and also the term del Q, which includes all the losses that take place during collision. So when the object collide with each other, it converts into another form of energy. That means heat, sound, light energy. So it will lose some amount of energy during the collision time. So note that loss in kinetic energy during the collision is transformed to another form of energy like sound, thermal, etc. Further, if the two colliding bodies stick together after collision, such collision are known as completely inelastic collision or perfectly inelastic collision. Such a collision is found very often. For example, when a clay putty is thrown on a moving vehicle, the clay putty or bubble gum stick to the moving vehicle and they move together with the same velocity. So this is a great example. So when the bubble gum stick to the moving vehicle and that they move together with the same velocity. So this is a very, very important topic, elastic collision and inelastic collision. Once again repeat, total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. It's nothing but elastic collision. Inelastic collision means total kinetic energy before collision is not is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. Thank you very much, children.